It is a capital mistake to theorize before you have all the evidence. It biases the judgment. Greetings to one and all. Today, I, Dr. Vashishtha Singh, a first-year postgraduate from the Department of Oral Medicine and Radiology, Seema Dental College and Hospital, Rishikesh, is here to present a review on my topic, Dental Autopsy and Adjunct in Identification of Missing Person. Next slide, please. These are the contents of my presentation. I'll be discussing each one of them. Next slide, please. So first, I would like to talk about forensic odontology. Forensic odontology has long been an essential discipline in the postmortem identification of human remains and determination of age of live subjects in a wider aspect of forensic investigations. And the word autopsy, it has been derived from a Greek word, autopsia, which means act of seeing for oneself. Then dental autopsy helps to make a proper post-mortem dental record. It primarily helps to register the teeth present in oral cavity, anti-mortem dental treatment received, study of dental malpositioning and type of occlusion. Next slide, please. Here are some basic instruments and components that are required in an autopsy kit. First, we have surgical blades and knives for making an incision. Then we have scissors, probes, dissecting forceps, managing glass and intraoral mirrors for proper visualization of the structures. Then we have labels, ultraviolet flashlights to distinguish between the tooth and tooth colored restoration, camera bag setup to keep camera accessories, a platform, camera and scale to take pictures at the site. Then the portable x-rays we have for field radiography, then computer x-ray sensors and card readers. We also have some tools like striker, which is used for bone cutting, looper, which is used for separating the jaws and one jaw opening lever. Other equipments that can be used are barrier equipments like gloves, face shield, masks and aprons. Next slide, please. Now, coming on to the antemortem records. For antemortem records, we gather as much as information possible, and then communicating with the family members and friends and dental offices can give us a whole lot of information about the person. And antemortem records can be collected in the form of x-rays, dental charts, photographs, and plaster models if the person has ever undergone any orthodontic treatment. Then here, this is shown an Interpol antemortem odontogram where all the informations are filled, antemortem records are all filled, and it gives us a dental status of the missing person. On to the next slide, please. After antemortem records, we have the postmortem record. In postmortem records, it is necessary first we take photographs prior to the autopsy. And consent is obtained from a medical and investigative officer for performing an oral autopsy. Then critical examination is done to know about the gender, age, ethnicity, build, and other considerations. Although examination of soft tissue injuries, fractures, and each tooth, whether it could be carious or restored or missing, it should be noticed. Then first we start with the autopsy. We have different types of incisions. One of them is first incision, that it is made from corner of the mouth to the tragus of the ear and it gives a wider view. Then a careful lip folding and cheek folding is done for the muscles, and oral cavity is properly viewed by and opened by traction. Then any prostheses or appliance or any foreign body material, whichever is present, it is to be removed, and a photographic record is obtained. This is a postmortem dental record chart, which is to be filled. Then we go for comparison and identification. So for comparing a antemortem and postmortem records, it can be done manually or as well as using computers. A detailed report and a factual conclusion is made on the basis of comparison, which includes a positive identification, possible identification, insufficient evidence, and exclusion. We have different systems for identification like CAPMI, which is a computer-assisted matching unidentified and missing persons. Then we have VINIT, which is a system for matching unidentified and missing person. NAMIS, which is National Missing and Unidentified System. And one of the most which is recognized is Interpol Disaster Victim Identification. Other outside agencies involved are NCMA, which is National Center for Missing Adults, and NCMEC, which is National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. Next slide, please. Then coming on to autopsy. Autopsy is a term which is extracted from two words, that is virtual and autopsy, and it employs managing in imaging methods that are also used in clinical medicine, such as CT, MRI, etc., for the purpose of autopsy and to find causes of the death. It avoids the need to physically dissect the corpse, which helps the investigator to discover important clues more quickly and effectively. The tools that are used for autopsy are 3D photogrammetry-based optical surface scanner, post-mortem CT, post-mortem CT guided biopsy, and post-mortem MRI. Next slide, please. So here's a literature review of two cases where one of the, in the first case, post-mortem clinical record like photographs of both the arches and occlusion, restoration, dental appliances, etc., and post-mortem radiographic records were compared with ante-mortem clinical and radiographic records respectively, and identity of a person was established. Then the post-mortem radiography helped us in ensuring shape of the restoration, dental radicular shapes, and any history of any endodontic treatment in the past, anatomy of maxillary sinus, etc. Then in the next case, in this case number two, there was a, in 2006, we found a skeletonized body in with no mandible in the coast of Veldris, Italy, and it was further investigated. Then in 2008, a mandible was found in the same place where the unknown corpse was found. And to compile a forensic odontological profile, a few examinations were done, like complete radiographic examination of both the arches, inspection with or without UV light, photographic examination, impression of arches, sampling of enamel and dental materials was done. The anthropological examination led to a positive confirmation that the mandible belonged to the skeletonized subject only. Next slide, please. Hence, I would like to conclude my topic by saying that the dental autopsy is a much faster and accurate and effective method for identification of a missing person or a missing corpse or a known identity. It can be considered as a better adjunct in identification process as the dental structures are really resilient to the outer disaster, any outer massive disasters or anything, and they cannot be destroyed because they are mostly covered in a very closed environment in the oral cavity and surrounded by the muscles. So they can be preserved for a longer duration, which gives us a more appropriate data. Next slide. Next slide, please. These are my references. Thank you for your keen hearing.